Okay, here we go. Pull that back up. I think we're okay. All right. I think this might be the last video, the last Ninja Turtle video. So here's where we're at. I went back in and touched the eyes back up. They don't look great, but there's nothing really short of freehanding them, which is basically what I had to do for most of it. They're just, some of them are missing the detail to make them look good. So I just kind of went in and did a couple little highlights on the red bandanas and had the white come back in. I think I might hit with some gray. They are a little bit too bright white for me, but I'm going to do all the weapons today. It shouldn't take that long. I'm going to start with, let me pull this off. I'm going to start with some brown. Fix something real quick. Sorry about this. It's auto focusing for some reason. There we go. Okay. Fixed. Okay. I did a couple things also as I moved. I feel like I'm always tweaking, which is fine. That's what I'm doing, is I'm tweaking and making sure everything, we're getting to the right spot. We're almost there. I moved a light, moved the microphone to the other side of the table, so to clear up this area so I'm not banging into it like I was, and I can reach for my water now with no problem. Only thing that it blocks now is a little bit of view of paint and some tools, but I had to screw and move things and whatever. Done. Anyway, sticks. So I have to I have two nunchucks to do and Donnie's staff. So it's kind of what I want to start with, is just kind of get that done. I'm going to start with some dryad bark, which is just a dark brown, and then kind of go up from there. I want to get these done because I have a wet palette video I want to make, and I have another tool coming that I want to make just a video of. So let's see what we can do first. And I'm just gonna use this brush. I really like, I don't think I've ever talked about it before, but the Army Painter brushes for basic, just everyday painting stuff. I love them. They, for my hands that are starting to get, I don't know, I've said this before, but I'm an art teacher. I use my hands nonstop. And these brushes tend to, they're hard. Things are getting harder to hold. Let me say that. But these like triangle shaped brushes, they feel great. And I wish more companies used that design. They feel so good in my hand. But so here we are. Actually, I might not be able to use this brush. I'll just tap it in, color around here. I did go over and paint some gray on where the tools should be. Or not the tools, but the like anything that was metal on the weapons. I'm gonna try and do these just fast. Get the. I can't use this brush, it's not pointy enough. So let's use this. Hope everybody's doing okay. You know, the world's a crazy place right now. That's okay. On to the other side. And he's kind of knuckling them, so it's, my hands are shaky today from did a lot of yard work yesterday, and then screwing and moving things around. Just kind of mess with my hands a bit. And caffeine. I always forget and then drink right before. Right, come on. Gotta get the back of this somehow. There we go. Set that aside for 1 second and get Donnie's stick. I think, yeah, the wraps I'm gonna do kind of like a parchment style, maybe, or something like that. Yeah. I'm gonna hit him with some sepia. So highlights, I'm just going to take some, I think, this kind of yellowish brown that I had before. Let's see. And it's all kind of dried up. And mix it in with, let me just grab, yeah, it's still right there. Too much time has gone by. I'm just kind of hit the top of this. That's not doing it for me. Take some of this. It's more of a reddish brown. Scrag brown. Mix that in. Need a little bit of, where'd it go? It's got moved. A bit of glaze medium. Yeah, see? So, telling you, it's only been, I think it's a week or something, but, I mean, it's still damp, but if I feel like this thing should be, have, I had this filled. Maybe it's me. I don't know. That's why the video is coming this week. Testing. That's okay. I'll take some white. This is the very tip. Do the same thing on these. Now, there's not a lot to do on these. Basically just going to tap in now. Yeah, let's do this. Some Xandri dust. That's what I'll use for the wrappings on the staff. Put it there. That way when I hit it with a wash, it'll kind of tint it a bit. Hard to get in here. Okay. Let's start with this one. Just gonna do just a quick Agrax Earthshade wash and get that on there. Putting it in my trusty holder so I don't spill. And this is just kind of oops. Forgot I was on camera for a second. Sorry. Just kind of getting it in there. Letting that kind of create a shadow on his hands. Gonna do the same thing on here, but I want to make sure this is dry. So I'm gonna hit it with the hairdryer real quick. Sorry for the noise. I move this as well. It's in a new spot. That should be fine. Okay, I'm gonna hit this whole thing. Actually, I'm gonna kind of keep it towards the back side and underneath. I'm gonna hit all of this.
Yeah.
Kind of just building up a shadow. The bottom edge of that stick. And then I kind of want that to be brighter. Take some of this ivory color and mix it with the Xandri dust. Can't see the ivory. It's way up there in the corner. It's from the other day. Still active. So I get barely just kind of touch here. Okay, now well, I'll let that dry. I think the eyes are a little too bright. So I'm going to try and probably make a huge mistake here. This is some contrast apothecary white. Got to give it a good shake. Let me see if, kind of just want to, yeah, that kind of tones it down. You're probably not going to see it on camera, but it definitely knocks that white back just enough. Yeah, there's a little touch-ups in here and there on that red, I think, but yeah, it does. It does its job. It did what I needed. Yay, contrast paint. Yep, done. Okay. So, weapons. Like I said, I had done some base coating with Storm Vermin. That's not what I want. It's just plain Eshin Gray. And I'm going to scoop some out here. I'm going to take some of this ivory. Reflection right on the and I'm going to get some of this, thin it out just a touch. Okay, so Since the light would be kind of shining straight down. Oops. Gonna just kind of I'm going to stay away from it. I'm going to try and not do metallics. The only thing I'm worried about is the gold on Leo's hilt looking too much like his chest. But we'll see. This. It's gonna have a light here. I'm gonna try and stay away from that backside because the way he's holding this one. I don't know if I'm happy with this or not. It's not something I normally do. I usually do metallics. But since I'm trying to keep them comic booky, thinking maybe I just use gray. Let's see. So this sword. I almost had it. Not as worried about the backside as I am the front. There isn't really a blade on here. It's just rectangular. Again, it's down to a sculpting thing. That's going to be gold, so I'm going to leave that. I'm trying to keep this as wet as possible. I'm gonna leave it there. So as far as this goes, it is gonna look very similar to their shells, the front plate of their shell. But like I said, I'm trying to keep it non-metallic, just so it looks a little more comic booky. Now, I'm going to take some Tau Light Ochre. I'm going to hit here, this side. It's really kind of a dark yellow. Over here. And I'm going to hit this edge. Hit there. Hit right there. I'm gonna kind of blend that out somehow. I'm gonna hit it with, do I have any white that's working? No. I'm gonna put like a tiny I mean, this is bad. Old. This is what I'm hoping will separate it from the front of his chest. It's just this tiny, 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 tiny. I'm running out of places. Tiny. Glint of white. Nah, don't like it. I don't like it. I don't like non-metallics. Never tried it, and I'm terrible at it. That looks better. Some of that color blended over it. Don't like his sword still. I wish there was a blade. It's just a rectangle. It's like a 2x4. Just checked it up. There. Maybe I should have closed that a long time ago. Let me take a break from that for a second. Let me think about it. Not good. It's not good. I forgot about this. Which would be Michelangelo's nunchucks. I don't think you can see what I'm doing over here because of the way the palette's working. That's a bit too white for me. But it might work. I won't worry too much about the backside of them. They're horribly out of scale anyway. think if I take some non oil, where are you? Just kind of tap it around in what should be those holes. Might fix some of that. Back into this, sorry. Okay. Leave that. I'll go back to these and kind of do the same thing, but work. Upwards a little. Okay. There's anything on here I want to maybe just a little bit under there so it's a little darker. Back to him. Want to get that white correct. It's just not letting me for some reason. I'm probably doing it wrong. And that's fine. Actually, that's not bad. I can live with it. Just reactivate some red here. Just plain red. And I'm gonna do just a couple final highlights. I think this turned out okay. I mean, I think I did the best I could with these in terms of what I started with. But I've seen some people do some really good work on these, and I don't know how they had the patience to deal with bad casting. Just don't anymore. These are messing up my I just found a spot on his nose. Oh, somebody had a spot on their finger. I think it was. Yeah, okay. So, I think I'm done. It's just a matter of the bases, which I'm going to use Corvus Black. It's kind of got a bluish gray tint to it, and I'm going straight out of the pot. I want this to look almost asphalty. Since they're game pieces, I'm not decorating these. And since most of their time is on a street somewhere. Gonna leave them kind of a gray. Wish everything was this easy. One down. Oh man, did I touched it. An idiot. One down. I think when I did my mousers, I painted just the bases black, so I'm not too worried about matching it, though. That's not terrible, I guess. I don't know. Again, focus is always one of my issues there. Could probably use to do two coats on these, but I'm gonna come back and do splinter another time.
he's still sitting right there. Almost done. Well, base coated. Mm-hmm. Almost. Just need to free this bench up for something new. Been working on these far too long. And I don't think the next thing is going to be a miniature. It's going to be a older plastic kit model. Okay. Well, that was dry in the last one. Well, if you stuck around from the beginning with all the camera issues, all the other trials here with this one, with the bad frame rate, the horrible bit, it's been crazy. But finally, I think everything's back to normal. New setup. And things can only get better now, I hope. But yeah, it's been... I feel like I've been working on these forever and through a bunch of madness. But yeah, done. There's probably a little couple things I'll check on them after letting them sit for a couple days and look at them. But for the most part, I think my turtles are finished. Finally, finally. Not awful. Not awful. Let those dry. Could be worse, I think. Man, that was tough. Okay, thanks for joining me. I'll talk to you later.